Such a lonely day.
Call Skid Row now. Skid Row now. How dangerous is it?
What's your name again?
My name is Charles.
Charles, how old are you?
I'm 62. And I'll be 62 three? June 12th.
All right.
When the year changed, I changed. I became homeless in 1992.
What do you think about the police officers around here and harassment?
Well,
yeah, there's one right there.
Well, okay. I'm on my team. They don't bother me because I stay to myself. I got out of penitentiary in 2003.
What were you in for, if you don't mind me asking?
I was in for, they call it receiving stolen property.
Receiving stolen property.
You know, but basically it was commercial burglary.
All right.
I went back to the penitentiary in violation. In 92. The end of 92.
Yeah.
Okay? So when I get off that violation, I come out here and I'll be homeless. Man, this shit here is what they call Skid Row now.
Skid Row.
And how dangerous it is and all
yeah.
that. Was, you know, this here is like cakewalk.
Yeah.
So I became homeless then in 94. I went in the L.A. Mission Program. I did 9 months and now I take 12 months to graduate.
How about family? You have any family?
Yeah. I've been in this town since 1947.
1947. So you got a bunch of family
born
around here.
In Arkansas.
Arkansas.
And like when my father came out in the 40s, my older brother and sister were already children when he sent for my mother from Arkansas. So every time he would knock her up, he'd send her back to her mother in Arkansas to have a baby. So I was born in my grandma's house.
Being homeless, I'm sure it affects you emotionally. Do you ever think about getting a job or, you know, proceeding your future?
Man, I'm disabled.
You're disabled. All right.
But I've had jobs. Matter of fact, I used to be a supervisor right there at the Ryan Garden.
All right.
From 1985 to 1987.
And all these people around, you know, all these normal people who walk by, they see you guys differently. You know, you guys are homeless. What do you think about
that? The normal people, I still have morals and I still
respect
for people.
Of course.
But don't care how much, what my situation is.
And how about drugs? Does it play a part of your life? You don't have to answer if you don't want.
I smoke marijuana.
Okay. How about alcohol?
I drink alcohol.
And what do you think of that? Do you like need that on daily to get by, function?
No, I don't do it daily.
You don't do it daily?
Because daily I don't have marijuana. You know.
That's just true.
And if I don't have the money, it doesn't bother me.
Yep.
You know, but normally I got beer money every day. But sometimes I got beer money and I won't buy beer because I need transportation back and forth.
Of course.
Neighborhood. You know, I suffer.
Yeah. So life out here is hard.
I suffer emotionally because I got a woman. Is pulling the other way, you know, and she's influenced by people in this environment.
How about religion? Are you religious?
Yes, I am.
You are.
See, set free ministry right there? That's my church.
That's your church. And you believe in God when things are down?
Yeah, I believe in God when things are down, sideways, or whatever. But because if it wasn't for Him, you would have drove up and wouldn't have seen people. Homelessness is big business. Big business. They call that shit about non-profit and all that, but that's bullshit, brother. That is bullshit.
I didn't know that.
And so the thing was from 30 days to 30 days, just like if I had rented a room at a motel. We'll be right back.
sir.
How you doing?
Good thing. What's your name?
Gomer.
Alessandro. I just want to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind, sir.
Go ahead.
About homeless people.
All right. So,
what do you think about homeless people in general?
Well, they are human beings, and as living beings, you know, they need a place to stay and sleep. And, you know, when it comes to food, you know, they need to be fed too. And if they can't do it, you know, by themselves, they should be aided, you know. As human beings, we should help each other.
So you think the government should help them?
Well, government helps
or
them
our fellow
a little
people.
Bit. Well, government's money comes from us, as taxpayers. We pay our taxes, we help them out. The government goes ahead and gives a little portion to them. But not as much. If you go into downtown streets, you will see there's hordes of them. And, you know, they're walking around pointlessly. Instead of putting them into rehab places and giving them a place to an address so they get a job so they can move on with their lives, we don't have that. You know, not enough funding.
True. And how do you think, most of them choose to be that way, or something in their life has brought them to this?
Well, as I've spoke to some of them like being homeless. You know, some of them believe in the nomad life and, you know, going from one place to another. But in general, they need a... I don't think anybody would want to be in their shoes. Nothing else?
And what would you do if you could, if you wanted to help a homeless person?
If I'm walking by and they ask for money, you know, I give them a couple of dollars, you know. I'm not a rich person, but as much as I can, you know, when I have the opportunity, I give them the money. You know, hopefully if God's big, you know, I win the lottery and I help many of them, touch many lives. But at the moment, I'm helpless.
Okay. Seems about it.
Thank you very much.
Nice talking to you, sir.
Have a good one.
You too. Thank you.